when we think about the average investor or the average Cardano enthusiast, people are putting a lot of energy towards this project, trying to enhance the community. I don't know if we can transition maybe to the Cardano Ambassador Program, but this is a program that basically highlights some of the community members that have really been putting their foot forward and want to see this project grow. Could you tell us a little bit more about the Ambassador Program and maybe some of the pillars or some of the milestones that you have to grow this program in the future?
So the basis of the Ambassador Program is to recognize our community members who are, like you mentioned, going kind of above and beyond the average user. They're committed to the project and they're contributing positive, high value things for the entire ecosystem. So when we launched end of December, beginning of January, we had identified four roles that we already saw in the community. So that's translators, so people taking the content that we officially publish and disseminating it into all of the other languages that we don't currently support. There's also the moderators. So Andy and Niels works closely with them right now. So that's across all of our channels. We need the help because obviously these are 24 hours. There's chat going on all the time. And we need to make sure these channels are both welcoming but informative to any new people that come in. We also have the meetup organizers, which we touched on before. So they are helping do local in-person events, teaching about the project, anyone who's interested. And then finally, content creators, which are people like yourself and Rick, creating content that we're not doing as a project, but is of extreme value to everyone in the Cardano community. So as a whole, the program is just about recognizing all these people. Anyone new who comes in can quickly identify an ambassador. They're almost like the second stage of answering questions or kind of figuring out what the project is all about. So yeah, we want to recognize them, acknowledge them, and move forward with them.
Yes, and a small fun fact, we are also meeting one of our ambassadors today here in London.
Excellent. Who's that?
Josh Monday.
Ah, Josh Monday. You know, I really like the Ambassador Program in a sense that what you're doing is you're fostering synergy. You're taking the synergy that already exists. People are already doing things that they like doing, and you're promoting it. You're kind of like feeding into it. If someone wants to be an ambassador, how do they go about doing it?
So right now, we're looking for people who are very engaged with the project. Not just want to become a Cardano ambassador because it looks cool or they get the tag or at some point they get some kind of incentives, but people who are generally interested with the project, want to help people, like to educate others, like to help others understand it. So those kind of people we're looking for. We do get sometimes applications of people who are just trying to become an ambassador, but without any previous contributions. And unfortunately, they get declined because there's a certain, a list of requirements that's necessary to become an ambassador in the first place. So we have to unfortunately tell them no. But if you're very active and you're very happy about, contributing towards this ecosystem, then you shouldn't have any problem becoming an ambassador in one of these roles that you're interested in.
Well, there you go. So simply the answer is make sure you meet the minimum requirements because there's a certain level of effort that would be required of an ambassador to be selected. It is a selective process. It's not a free-for-all. And there is a link on the Cardano forum. We'll put the link in the comments down below that Maki had posted earlier this year. It gives you a description of the ambassador program. It tells you about all the different roles that Maki had just mentioned. You can read into greater detail there. And if you meet those requirements, feel free to enter your information to be selected for an ambassador, or you can reach out to me. I've nominated a couple of people. Some may have been selected, some weren't. That's okay. That's fine. That happens. But as time goes on and people get some more activities done, then maybe they'll get selected. But you guys have to make tough decisions.
To make it really simple, if you're interested, then the best thing to do is start making contributions. Like, if you don't want to go through the process of like reading the terms and all the rest of it, then all you need to know is start creating some content, start helping, start contributing, because just some records of you contributing is going to be a huge factor in you getting selected. So if you wanted to keep it simple, just start doing something, you know, start doing it today, start contributing a little bit.
Excellent. Thank you, Ben. And Ben, I liked your comments earlier about how you listen to what other people have to say, and then you try to understand the perspective of where they're coming from. I just wanted to make note, you reminded me of, if you ever heard of Dr. Stephen Covey, Stephen Covey's, one of his 7 habits of highly effective people is seek first to understand and then be understood. And after I heard you say that, I realized, wow, Ben is actually employing that usage, that technique. That's excellent, man.
You know, something you said that I liked and is very true is that basically people in a community self-select, like in terms of their value and contributions. It isn't our job to tell people whether they will be valuable or not. They determine whether they're going to contribute value to that community. So it's like, I feel like people are on the fence sometimes, like, well, you know, how am I going to contribute? What am I going to do? But from our point of view, we're just looking for people that are putting that effort in, putting that work in, you know? And that's what's exciting. Like, it's such an interesting space. Whatever you're doing in your life, I think that contributing to a project like this can often give a lot of experience and interest that can help the project, but it's good for you as well, right? Like, you wanted to start a blog, we'll start writing something. You want to do podcasts, start doing something, right? This is just a vehicle for you to become competent in whatever it is that you're interested in as well as helping us. Like, there should be value for you as well. And I know the team is really keen to support that. So, yeah, you'll be seeing lots of ways that will be happening.